Okay, I'm going to go through some IK systems. Now, there's a number of different IK systems built into Maya. We've got a few here that I've just listed off. There's 8 that exist, and some of them you will probably use, and some of them you probably won't. So starting off with the first ones, you have to use create node each time you want to use these. So you'd have to create node, give the name, and put a semicolon at the end of it. This one's a 3D chain. This guy is a hidden solver from the old days, so really you could probably eliminate him right away. He's basically the same thing as the RP solver, it's just an older version of that. And this guy right here, however, is actually in your wonderful help menu. So if you went through your Maya help, you would find him in there. And basically what he's described as being useful for is things like tentacles and stuff like that, and we're going to make one of them right here. These guys here, they have to be turned on as a plugin first, so you turn on the plugin and then you will have to invoke them once, and after that they'll always be available inside the menus. These guys exist within the menus up top, and this guy of course requires a special setup in order for him to work. So you can see right here the two-bone solver. It's basically the same thing as an RP solver, it's just a faster solver. It allows you to do things as a calculation based on the first, what you would call a bone, even though it's not a bone system, it's two joints. So between the first two joints and the last two joints, and it does that solve there, so it's a bit faster. It basically ignores everything else. Then we have the spring solver, which takes all the individual joints, and in between them, it does an even bending of all of them. Then the RP solver uses a chain up vector, which is called a pole vector inside of Maya. We have the SC solver, which rotates directly from the handle for twist values. And then of course the spline solver, which uses a curve. So let's first start off with the IKMC solver, so multi-chain solver. So I'm going to type create node, capital C, capital N. IK, capital M, capital C, solver, and a semicolon, which is right next to the L on your keyboard. Sorry, that's not a capital C, that's a lowercase c. And that will create the node. And that's how that will work. So good practice would actually be having the node editor open first. But there it is, that's my MC solver, and I'm just going to go ahead and show you that. So my MC solver is here, and then I'm going to go ahead and under animation, so you can have it from the tab here, that's your IK handle, or skeleton IK handle tool, open up that, and we can create a rotation plane solver or an SC solver or whatever we want. To start this off, it's going to create the node. I'm just going to give me that. And I'm just going to grab these two guys here and look at their inputs. And you'll see the RP solver exists right here. And there's my new MC solver, which is right there. So what I'm going to do with this is I'm actually going to expand this one. And you can see that it goes into the IK solver here. But you notice this guy's end is basically looking like it's white instead of blue. Well, what we're going to do here is we're going to hold down shift, middle mouse button, drag and drop. Just going to open up this. I've already turned on the non-keyable and show hidden on both sides so that I can see all my connections. They can become a bit heavy if you do that, but just if you need to access them, because otherwise sometimes things don't show up. So I've turned those on. I'm going to go message to my IK handle, IK solver right here. So message to IK solver, and that's going to link those up. And you notice it's now turned blue and the connection has been made. So what this has done here is it's now a multi-chain solver instead of a regular IK solver. And as I move this, you notice it does some funkiness. So this is a 3D chain, and one of the things with the 3D chain is that it works from multiple angles and it can be adjusted. So you can go ahead and adjust things like that and key that, and you get the movement there. You'll notice that it will sometimes, it'll curl or curve in one direction or another, which you can also adjust. You can adjust these things to go that direction as well. Really whatever you want. And that IK will still function. So the idea here is to use this, all the bones in here, so you're basically at the same time using IK and FK simultaneously, and it works in multiple different directions, which leads to potentially unpredictable results. However, the intended use of this would be something like a octopus tentacle or something like that, in order to get some kind of fast, sort of like a wiggling movement or something like that off of a tentacle, if you wanted to do that sort of movement. And that's basically all you would probably use this for. So this is a regular 3D chain. Now, like I said, if you want to use that, you have to invoke it every single time. The other ones, so you want to get them into action, go to your plugin manager. And we have in here your IK two-bone solver and your IK spring solver. And then, of course, your Maya HIK is right there. So if we go to skeleton IK handle tool, you can see by, looks like, oh, now that I had invoked it, it looks like it's now showing up, which just didn't happen the previous time. So for whatever reason, this is now suddenly showing up, which is bizarre to me. But there it is. And I'm going to go ahead and invoke the other ones. Let's go ahead and just write IK spring solver, semicolon, see if I got that right. No valid items selected, which is fine. Doesn't need to have them selected. You just want to invoke it and it should show up in your IK handle tool now. So I've got the rotation plane solver, the HIK, the spring solver, and the single chain solver are all in here. And then of course you can do the same thing here. IK 2 capital B solver semicolon, which should also give me funkiness, and that should show up as well. So there's my two bone solver, my spring solver, HIK solver, rotation plane, MC, and then single chain. So now they're all available. Now I have them all at my disposal for every time I open up Maya, which is kind of cool.